Hey everyone, it's Warriors NRL Fanatics here. Hope you're all doing well. If you are a new viewer to this YouTube channel or a returning viewer to the channel, please make sure you don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Click that subscribe button down below. Shows all your support for the content that I do. It also helps the channel to grow and gets the word out about the content as well. Helps the algorithm, and it's absolutely free and it's much appreciated as well. I'd like to thank everyone for subscribing. Don't forget to like this video as well. Make sure you click the thumbs up button and click the bell so you're notified when I upload any new content next on the channel. Now, some news going around the club this week, and there's been plenty of it. And I'll start with the first bit of news and give my thoughts. And that is on the sold-out games at Go Media Mount Smart Stadium this year. That's right. The Warriors have become the first NRL club in history to sell out every home game in 2024. And boy, what an achievement for the club. Look, you got to think of it this way. The Warriors, obviously, you know, being back in New Zealand has really, you know, helped the club out again. You know, we've had to suffer through the years during COVID period. Obviously, being based in Terrigal, Central Coast, Redcliffe, and off the back of the success of last season, really definitely helped the case as well with the Up the Wars movement, has really, you know, tailed into this season as well, and given the club another boost as well. So, look, I think for me, it's just great for Rugby League in New Zealand as a whole to see it sell out every game this year. And, you know, if you look at form this year by the boys on the field, results have not gone our way. You know, we're not sitting well on the ladder. We shouldn't be where we are on the ladder at this point in time. But, you know, look, to see the fans still loyal and getting out there and watching the games at home just shows where the club is heading at the moment, and the fact that the fans are so loyal and dedicated to this team. And, look, well done to the Warriors, well done to the club, well done to the fans, because selling out every game at home this season is a great achievement nonetheless. And, you know, to be that one of the first NRL clubs to do it is an achievement nonetheless. So, yeah, well done to the club, and it's good to see. It's really good to see, despite, you know, we were sitting on the ladder, you know, it could easily be, you know, fans could easily decide not to attend games this year because we're not where we are, we want to be. But there are a lot of loyal fans out there. But they also would know there can be a few bandwagon supporters that just jump on when we're winning. So, yeah, it's a great to see. And well done to the club there on selling out every home game in 2024. And looking forward to 2025, where we see if we can make any more history and sell out a few games in a row. But it's great to see nonetheless. Now, another bit of news that just broke today, and it was actually rumoured for a few days now, was on New Zealand Warriors veteran forward. Veteran? I'll call him veteran because, you know, he's been around for a bit now. And that is Jazz Tavanga. And Jazz Tavanga confirmed on a podcast that he will not be at the One New Zealand Warriors in the 2025 season. And now the Warriors have officially come out and confirmed on Facebook, on Instagram, on their website, that Jazz will not be at the club next season. So, yeah, look, you know, look, whatever you say about Jazz, whether you're a fan of him or whether you're not a fan of him, you know, Jazz puts everything into the jersey, right? He is such a passionate player, man. He goes out there and he never disappoints for me, right? And I absolutely love Jazz Tavanga. Now, albeit he's had a tough few years now with a couple of injuries, it's just not helped him at all, but giving him less time on the field, more time on the sidelines, which is, you know, a shame, because, you know, we know when Jazz is on the field what he can bring to the table. So, look, if you look at it, you know, obviously for me as a fan, it's pretty gutting, it's pretty sad that Jazz won't be at the club next year, because, you know, I'd love to see him stay at the Warriors for longer, no doubt about it. You know, that would have been awesome. But also, look at this, You know, the Warriors at the moment have some good young forwards coming through the system. So, you know, look, a couple of years ago, I probably would have said if Jazz left, you know, that's a big hole to fill. You know, I would have said that. But right now, Jazz leaving, I see it more of as a positive for Jazz and the club moving forward, because Jazz can, you know, look at his future moving in another direction. You know, there's apparently a few other clubs interested in him. I wouldn't be surprised if he goes off to the Super League, goes over to the UK, or maybe another NRL club might sign him. But look, you know, Jazz just really is one of the true Warriors, right? He's a true Warrior, a legend as well, very humble human being, you know, a very nice bloke. Met him a few times in person, and I gotta say, obviously, as sad as it is to see him leave, I wish him all the best to him and his family. And yeah, I hope he, whatever he does next, I wish him all the best for the future moving forward, and good luck to him. And look, if it's for another NRL club, hopefully he doesn't play well against us, but if it's for another club in the Super League, good luck to him over in the Super League if he does go there. So yeah, it's look, it really isn't a surprise really for me, right? You know, it really isn't a surprise. I kind of had that feeling that he wouldn't re-sign for the Warriors in 2025. I had that feeling that he may leave at the end of the season. So yeah, man, look, nice bloke Jazz, man. He's an absolute legend for me, a true Warrior, always a Warrior through and through, in my opinion. And yeah, I wish him nothing more but the best for the future, and good luck to Jazz as well. But yeah, look, also another player which has been rumored to be leaving the club is Dylan Walker. That's right, Dylan Walker. And boy, apparently there's been some rumors for a while around the Warriors fans circle that I think there was talks that Dylan Walker and his wife apparently split, so there's something going on in the background. So it says, reported by 9 Moly, Channel 9 Mole, and a few other media outlets, that Dylan Walker will not be at the club next season. He is going back to Australia due to personal reasons. So those personal reasons, you know, it doesn't say, but there's some talks that him and his wife split, so maybe that would probably be the reason why that he will go back to Australia next year. But look, Dylan Walker, man, I feel like he's done a very good job for us. You know, he's been Mr. Fix-It, you know, played a great role last year in helping this team into a top four spot. You know, obviously he played off the bench as a utility, and did a great job there. He's played a bit of the halves, he's played in the forwards. You know, look, I feel like Sir Dylan Walker's been at the Warriors only for a short period, but he's done a great job for us, right? And then, you know, I feel like, yes, it'll be a bit of a loss for the club, but then again, we look at our other players we've got in the pathways and the juniors teams that we can bring forward, New South Wales Cup, bring into the side. I feel like we've still got enough depth to cover in both Jazz and Dylan Walker's departures, if Dylan Walker does leave, and of course Jazz is leaving. So, you know, nonetheless, you know, these things can happen. You know, players can leave. Obviously, as fans, we love to see them stay a bit longer, but you know, they have their reasons. And as fans, all we're gonna do is wish them all the best, and good luck to. Good luck to Jazz. Good luck to Dylan Walker as well. But yeah, let me know your thoughts down in the comments below. Jazz Tavanga leaving at the end of the 2024 season, and yeah, looking at his career, going into this week's games, he's playing his 134th match on Friday night against the Eels at GoMeter Stadium, and he has And he's 28 years old, Jazz Tavanga, and he's been at the Warriors for 9 seasons in the NRL. 9 seasons, which is quite long, isn't it? It's quite a long time at the club. So, you know, like Andrew McFan says here, we're grateful for what Jazz has done for the Warriors, and we appreciate his efforts over the time. So yeah, we definitely do, us fans, and I know the team does as well. Yeah, and also yeah, he's also played 45 times for the under 20s in 2014 and 15, and made 25 New South Wales Cup appearances since 2015. For the Warriors there, but yeah, let me know what your thoughts are on this news, guys. Jazz leaving, Dylan Walker potentially leaving. I think Dylan Walker looks like a certainty to happen. But yeah, guys, make sure you like this video. Please click that thumbs up button on the video. It shows your support and your appreciation for the content as well. And please don't forget to subscribe. Make sure you click that subscribe button, because subscribing, guys, is absolutely free. Doesn't cost anything at all, and it's a much pressure. Shows your support for all the content that I do as well. And thanks for watching, everyone. Up the Waz, go the Warriors, and yeah, I'll see you guys all in the next one. Cheers.